again, Welcome. Thank you for that warm welcome. I invite you to join me in one more warm welcome, particularly to the families of not only our oaks, but also our acorns. So if I could ask the parents and families of our acorns and oaks to please stand as you're able and receive our thanks and our welcome. Like you, like all of us, my life has seen periods where I was both an acorn and an oak. At my school when I was growing up, I was a lifer. I went all the way from pre-kindergarten to 12th grade at the same school. Mrs. Turner, who I met at school, she came almost as an oak. She came in 11th grade. And my children have attended several different. Whether you came as a pre-care, kindergartner, first grader, or just recently, whomever you are both an acorn and an oak, whether lifer or oak, whether lifer and oak, we have so much to learn, so much to teach. Interestingly, tomorrow, October 5th, is World Teacher's Day. Some of you already know this. In their statement, stated the following. We celebrate the work of dedicated teachers around the world who continue to strive every day to ensure that inclusive and equitable quality education and the promotion of lifelong learning opportunities for all become a reality in every corner of the globe. Later this month, in the next community letter, you'll be reading about how we do that here at Chipley to encourage lifelong learning among the colleagues and the adults in the community. Today, we present, Oaks will present to their acorns a pencil box. And I'd ask all of you to consider, as you see that happen, to consider the idea that that pencil box represents not just the friendship between Oaks and acorns, but it also represents our shared commitment to educational excellence, the love of learning, not only for the students you see in front of you today, but for all of us, students, families, colleagues, guests, for all of us, we are both acorns and oaks. We learn and we teach every day. We have so much to learn and so much to teach. So thank you for being here with us today to celebrate that, and I'd like to welcome to the podium our all-school president, Douglas.
Staring up at the seniors, wondering how I could share a school with people who looked so old and so put together that they were practically adults. This is funny for me to think about now, considering I couldn't even tell you what class I had after this. However, these words still ring true to me today. The seniors who were here when my grade entered pre-K are now currently 30 years old. Many of them probably have kids ready to start school themselves. They grew up in a very different social, political, and economic climate than we did, and the current little Acorns will work in a world more different still. However, the Oaks to Acorns ceremony, and, by extension, the Shipley community, has remained a constant throughout. We have all had the unique opportunity to be a part of a place that values community so much it can take something as simple as a pencil box and turn it into a bridge between generations. To my fellow seniors, I know that many of you have been waiting for this moment for a very long time. We'll have many great moments together this year, so I ask you to make this a great moment. With Little Acorns, I ask you to keep the wonderful energy that you all have and take it with you throughout the rest of your Shipley career and your life. Though you may never know the wonders of mid-2000s Disney Channel Nickelodeon, and I may never understand how the song Baby Shark became so popular, together we are the bookends of this school community. So, whether you use your pencil box to actually hold pencils, put it up on your shelf, or even just stick it in your backpack and forget about it, I hope that you at least remember this moment as the moment the class of 2020 welcomes the class of 2031, 2032, and 2033 to the Shipley community.
Wow.
I know you all are probably very eager to get started, and I am too. So, my name is Declan Buckley, and I am your all school president. Thank you.
Sharing this relationship with the lower school students is so meaningful to me, especially after seeing so many previous Oaks to Acorns assemblies. For us seniors, this is just the start of an exciting last year together, full of many traditions such as this one. Thank you so much for listening, and please enjoy the Oaks to Acorns ceremony. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Matthew Lazursa, and I am in the 11th period. Gideon Addis.
Good morning, my name is Rudy Grimming and I'm in the 10th grade. Paxton Showerman. Preston Shaw. Madeline Beauchamp. Jaden Becker.
Chase McCall.
Mary Elizabeth.
David Swall. Ben Turabi. Callan Williams. Charlotte Grillo. Hudson Bergen. Sadie Glasson. Joe Sunspenner. Angie Tiago. Beatrice Wesley. Darian Wolcott. Roman Fraud. Jason Black. Vivian Hannah. Gabby Johnson. Thomas Lucas.
featured a group of musicians called the Villalobos Brothers. They shared some of their music, which is a mix of Mexican folk, jazz, and classical music. It was heartwarming for me to hear the sounds of sonnet jarocho and Spanish lyrics. Music is a beautiful thing because it can take you to a different place and time. Listening to the Villalobos performance took me back home to my natal state of Veracruz, Mexico, with its loud streets, warm weather, friendly people, and delicious food. I met them afterwards, and we greeted each other with a kiss and a hug. Even though we were just meeting, we were not strangers. We shared so much. They are my people. It is so important to embrace who we are, our roots and our story, and celebrate it because it is what makes us.
Gracias, señor Antonio. So we're going to continue that celebration in the celebration of our oaks and acorns with a piece by Tito Puente called Oye Como Va. Thank you.
continue to see and know and learn from each other in your authentic selves, and you would have a wonderful day, a wonderful weekend, and a wonderful school year. So thank you again for joining us today.